नीतिकृतनियमरहितां प्रादैकमयीम् अनन्यपरतन्त्रां नवरसरुचिरां निर्मितिम् आदधति भारती कवेर्जयति. लुकिङ्ग् एट् द दोषास् वी हेव् टु गो आन् टु वाक्यदोषास् नौ. लेट् मी टेक् अप् द बुक् मेट् अपास्य च्युतसंस्कारम् असमर्थं निरर्थकं वाक्येऽपि दोषाः सन्ति एते पदस्यांशे अपि केचन केचन न पुनः सर्वे क्रमेण उदाहरणं. नौ द 13 डिफरेण्ट् दोषास् दट् हि सेट् बिफोर् आर् नाट् 13 एक्चुलि द 16 दोषास् अमङ्ग् द 16 दोषास् दट् हि सेट् फार् पददोषास् ओन्ली 13 आफ् देम् आर् गोयिङ्ग् टु बि can be expressed in as vakya dosha also. There can be vakya dosha in that also. So he does not talk about chuta samskriti, asamartham and nirarthakam. Yeah, so chuta samskaram, asamartham, nirarthakam, apasya. Without chuta samskara, asamartha and nirarthaka, the rest, all of those, including the three kevala samasagata doshas, that is klishtam, avimrishta videyamsha and viruddhamatikrita, can occur in vakya doshas. Among all of these, only some can be pada amsha also. Pada amsha means like just the pratipadikam or the karakam or just the pratyaya problem is there. These things can occur only for some of the doshas can occur, but not everything can occur in pada amsha. Now for each and everything we are going to look at udaharanam. So we are going to have 13 doshas along with their examples. The first one is shruti katu in vakya gata. Shruti katu we saw was I think kartarthyam. So kartarthyam was the word. The difference between padagata dosham and vakya gatam dosham for each and everything is padagatam means in one shloka you will have only one word that is a problem, whereas in vakyagatam you will have many words in that shloka do not go with the sense that is there or the rasam that is there. It is not rasa anugunam in that shloka. So vakyagatam means many words are affected in that shloka, not only one word, whereas in padagatam means only one word is affected. Okay, so the first example he gives is so adhyeshta vedan tridashan ayashta pitran atarpsit amamstha bandhuna vyajeshta shadvargam aramstha neeto samula ghatam nyavadhit arimscha. This is a shloka from Bhattikavya. In the Prathama Sarga he describes Dasharatha talks about the different qualities or what all he did. First he studied the Vedas. Saha Vedana Adhyaishta. Even the words that he uses are very difficult because his concentration was more on Vyakaranam. So Saha Vedana Adhyaishta. Dasharathaha Vedan Adhitavan. So he studied all the Vedas. Tridashana Ayashta. Devana apujayat. He performed yagas for all the devas. Pitrana atarpsit santosham akarot. So he atarpayat, instead of atarpayat, he uses atarpsit. It's a very difficult usage also. Being his main aim being to bring out that the Panini Sutra connected with those and so pitrana atarpsit, he performed tarpana for all his ancestors. Bandhuna amamstha, bandhuna sadarena apashyat. So he looked at all his he respected or regarded all his relatives very highly. Bandhuna amamstha shadvargana vyajeshta vijayati vyajayat shadvargan shadvargam vyajayat. Shadvargaha is the kama krodha lobha moha mada matsarya, the six enemies that are there in our mind, that is your shadvarga. the six problems are the enemies of the mind, which do not let you go into the proper path, follow the proper path. That is the Shadvargam. It is also called the Arishadvarga, their enemies. So Arishadvargam Vyajeshta, he won over all the six enemies of the mind, Kama, Krodha, etc. Nitav Aramsta, Ramate means enjoyed. Aramsta means he enjoyed being, or enjoyed that Niti Shastra, the policy, Rajaniti. Dasharatha, not only, you know, he was very good at all these things, he was also very involved in the policies that Chanakya Niti or Shukra Niti, etc. So Nitav Aramsta, he enjoyed politics, not enjoyed, he did everything in accordance to politics, Niti Shastra. And then Arinscha Sa Moola Ghatam Nyavadhit, he killed all his enemies from the root. Sa Moola Ghatam, along with the Sa Moolam Hatavan. Okay. Now, in this, all the words, Aneka Pada Gatam, that is why this is Shruti Kathu. It is very difficult to for the ears. So it is very harsh to the ears. And many words are very harsh to the ears. Not just one word like Kartarthyam, which we saw in Padagata Dosham. Here, many words like, so Adhyaishta Vedans Tridashan Ayashta. The usage of Shakara, Takara and Samyukta Akshara, like Pitrun Atarpsit Amamsta Bandhun. Vyajeshta, it's like a tongue twister for me. Vyajeshta Shadvargam Aramsta Nitav Samula Ghatam Nyavadhit Arimscha. We have to really open our mouth wide and to say the shloka properly. So it's a nice example for this dosha, which is Vakya Gatam Shruti Katu. The next is, let me show this table which I had made, because it's easier to know what the Padagata Dosham was and what the Vakya Gatam Dosham is. So it's easier. So for Shruti Katu, we had Kartarthyam, and here we have the So Adhyayishta. For Aprayuktam, Aprayuktam means even though Koshe Patidam Abhi Kavi Prayuktam Na Vidyate. The example we saw in Padagatam was Daivataha, where he uses Daivataha Pishachova. I don't know what has gone into his mind, and that is why he is performing such Darune Karmani Saha Raktaha Asti, Saktaha Asti. So in that shloka, we saw that just the word Daivataha is generally Daivatani Pumsiva, is the Kosha, Koshe Patitam Asti. Hence, it can be used in Pullinga also, but it is not used in Pullinga by Kavi. Whereas if you use it in Pullinga, it is called Aprayuktam is the dosha. So the example here he gives is, what's the next one? I think it's easier for me to keep the text also. Saratu vo duschyavano bhavukanam paramparam aneda mukataadyaihi cha dyatu doshaihi asammatan. Saratu vo duschyavano bhavukanam paramparam. Saratu vo duschyavanaha. Duschyavanaha is Indra. In the, it is Amarakosha. In Amarakosha, it is given Sankrandano duschyavanaha. Duschyavanaha Turashan Meghavahanaha. So there are words that they have used for Indra. There are so many words that you can find in Vedas and Purana. But it is not used commonly in Kavya, which is Duschyavana is a word for Indra. And that is not something you see. You can see Maghava, Maghonaha. In Meghasandesha also, he uses the word Maghonaha many times. Maghavan is used many times. Whereas we've never seen the word Duschyavana being used. Let's look at the meaning of this. So, Duschyavanaha Vaha Bhavukanam Paramparam Ratu Saha Duschyavanaha. Let that Indra Ratu give. What does he, let him give you all Vaha Yushman. Yushmakam bhavukanam paramparam. Parampara is a series of bhavuka. Bhavuka is auspicious things. Mangala. Mangala vastunam paramparam dadatu, santatim dadatu, ratu. And then what should he also do? Not only should he give us all good things, he should also give bad things to enemies. What a prayer this is. I just don't understand. Asammatana shatrun api doshaihi dyatu. Let him destroy all the enemies with dosha, with vyadhi. What are the vyadhi? Aneda mukataadyaihi cha doshaihi asammatana dyatu. Those who are not in concordance with me, na sammataha asammataha, tukte virodha, virodhi, virodhina, virodhihi api. those who are all on the opposite side. So shatrun api aneda mukataadyaihi. Eda mukata, aneda mukata means badhira and muka. Badhira, disability of hearing, and muka is speech disability. So let him destroy the shatrus with the different disabilities that you can find in the world. So here, aneda muka. Muka means those who cannot speak. Aneda means those who cannot hear. So vak shruti varjitam aneda mukam. Even though it is said in the kosha, in Medini kosha you find aneda muka uddishtaha shathe vak shruti varjite. So aneda muka is generally used as an abuse for a dhurta or a durjanaha, for a bad person. You cannot use it as a dosha per se by indicating the disability here, right? Let my enemies be affected by deafness and not speaking. That is what someone is praying to Indra here. So sa duschyavanaha vaha bhavukanam paramparam ratu. Let him give you the series of auspicious things, and let him asammatana dyatu, let him destroy the enemies with the faults, doshaihi, or disabilities like aneda mukataadyaihi, like deaf and dumb and etc. These are the things that someone is praying to Indra. Now here, duschyavana, atra duschyavana indraha aneda mukaha mukabadhiraha. Now mukabadhira is a term that you can use to indicate the disability itself. If there is a person, two people are fighting and they are abusing each other, then you can use the word aneda muka for durta or durjana. You cannot use it to indicate directly this. Even though koshe patitaha api na kenachit prayujyate. Saratuvo duschyavano bhavukanam paramparam aneda mukataadyaischa dyatu doshair asammatan. Next one is nihatartham. Nihatartham is, so there are different meanings for one word, but at the same time, you are using an aprasiddhartha, prasiddhyarthe upayujyate. When there is a prasiddhyartham, like Padma, when there is a prasiddhyartha, you are using the aprasiddhartha, unconventional meaning. That which is not popular usage, that which is not a popular usage, you're using the unpopular usage for those words. It is a guna in Slesha or in Yamaka, where you are talking about Chitrakavyam and you want to show two meanings for a word, so it is Slesha. There it is a guna, whereas in a place where Slesha is not intended, and you're using a different, when we see the shloka, you'll understand. Then it is a dosha. Sayaka sahaya bahoho makaradhvaja niyamita kshamadhipatehe abja ruchi bhaswarahate bhatitaram avanipa shlokaha. He avanipa te shlokaha bhatitaram. That's the main sentence here. He avanipa, he rajan, te shlokaha. Now what is the first meaning that will come to our mind when we say te shlokaha? Oh, the verse on you, or your verse, the verse that you have said, the shloka that you have said. No, but here he actually wants to mean tava yashaha, tava kirtihi. usage we have seen shloka, when we say punya shloka, महान् पुण्यश्लोकः मीन्स् पुण्य पुण्यं पुण्याकीर्तिः यस्य सः इति पुण्यश्लोकः. सो अ पर्सन् अ ग्रेट् पर्सनालिटि हू हेज़् अ बिग् फेम् हू हेज़् अ ग्रेट् फेम् और् अ वेरि प्योर् फेम् फार् दट् पर्सन् वि यूस् द वर्ड् श्लोक इन् द मीनिङ्ग् आफ् यशस् ओन्लि एस् अ समास इन् पुण्यश्लोक. वेर् इस् हियर् इन् दिस् He has taken out the word shloka, even though it means yashas. He has taken it to mean as yashas here, separately. So, te shlokaha bhati taram. Your fame is shining very much. It has a kanti. How is it? Abja ruchi bhaswaraha. It is bhaswaraha. It is shining. Very beautiful, like the beautiful ruchi. It is very beautiful, like abja. Abja means he's using it in the meaning of chandra here, because yashas is white and it is compared to the moon. Abja also means chandra. One minute. Correct. Yeah, abja means chandra also. So abja ruchi bhaswaraha. अब्ज चन्द्रस्य रुचिः कान्तिः इव भास्वरः यः तव श्लोकः आर् यत् तव यशः. सो योर् फेम् इस् वेरि ब्यूटिफुल् अण्ड् शैनिङ्ग् लैक् द चन्द्र. नौ ते द फस्ट् टू वर्ड्स् इन् द फस्ट् लैन् आर् एड्जेक्टिव्स् टु द किङ्ग्. सो योर् फेम् शैन्स् वेरि ब्यूटिफुलि लैक् द मून्. देट् इस् डन्. नौ हौ आर् यू? हौ इस् द किङ्ग्? He gives two adjectives. One is sayaka sahaya bahoho. Your hand has the sword for a helper. Sayaka. Sayaka is actually used in the meaning of khadga here and not bana. Generally, in Kavyam, you will find the usage of sayaka as bana or arrow and not as sword. So here he uses it in the meaning of sword and says sayaka sahaya bahoho. You have the sword as a help for your hand. Tadrishaha tava. The other meaning, other word is makara dhvaja niyamita kshama adhipatehe. Kshama adhipati. You are the king, ruler of this kshama, this earth. So, and that rule is being stopped by makara dhvaja. Makara dhvaja. Makara is crocodile. One who has the crocodile in his dhvaja as his chinnam, as his ketu or his flag. One who has the crocodile as the flag is the samudra. So makara dhvaja also means manmatha. Makara dhvaja also means samudra here. So generally it is used in the meaning of kama, manmatha, whereas here he uses it in the meaning of samudra. सो मकरध्वजः तु समुद्रे उपयुक्तः अत्र. सो समुद्रनियमित क्षमा अधिपतिः. हिस् रूल् इस् बीङ्ग् स्टाप्ड् बै दि ओशन्. सो हि डस् नाट् रूल् दि ओशन्, हि रूल्स् दि एण्टैर् अर्त् विच् इस् सरौण्डेड् बै दि ओशन् अण्ड् हिस् रूल् एक्स्टेण्ड्स् अप् टु दि ओशन्, विच् मीन्स् देर् इस् नो पोर्शन् दट् डस् नाट् कम् विद् इन् हिस् रूल्. हि रूल्स् दि एण्टैर् अर्त्. तादृशः तव हे राजन् तव कीर्तिः भातितराम् अतिशयेन वर्तते. नौ द वर्ड्स् ऐ सेड् सायक मकरध्वज सायकादयः शब्दाः खड्ग अब्धि भू चन्द्र यशः पर्यायाः शरादि अर्थतया प्रसिद्धाः. Just gives as a capsule here. We have to take it as yathasankhyam. Yathasankhyam means we have to match the following now. Sayakadayaha shabdaha. Let us take each and every word here. Sayaka, then makaradvaja, kshama. Kshama also means patience. It also, because there is no one who can be more patient than the earth. She is the one who takes up so much of bharam. People, you know, we talk about how the population keeps on increasing day by day. So many births occur, and the births are much more than the deaths. Because of the advance of science, we find that there is so much of bharam, and yet this earth doesn't fall down in that with the weight, right? She is able to bear the entire weight. So she's the one who is patient, the most patient person. So that's why krama, even though it means patience, it is also indicative of bhuhu, the earth. So here sayaka is khadga, makaradvajaha samudraha abdhihi, krama bhumihi yashaha. So abja is chandraha, shlokaha yashaha. Kintu ete shabdaha, etesham shabdanam prasiddharthaha sayakasya sharaha, and makaradvajasya kamaha manmathaha, krama ityasya gunam, krama kshantihi, abja padme, then shlokaha to verse kavye, right? These are the prasiddharthaha, whereas he has not used it in that prasiddhartham. He has used it in the aprasiddhartham. That is why the dosha here is nihatartha. Nihatartha tiraskrita arthe. That which is not properly used. So the dosham here is nihatartham. So the prakrityartha covers up, the prasiddhartha, the popular meaning completely overshadows the meaning that the poet wants to convey. With this shloka, the poet actually wants to convey that sayaka is a sword and it is not shara. Whereas the moment we hear the word sayaka, the n number of poets have used the word sayaka as only bana. So that popular meaning overshadows the vivakshitartha. So prasiddhyarthena prakritarthasya tirodhanam nihatarthatvam. I think in padagatam, the word was shonitam. Instead of rakta, the where he wanted to use that, the foot is reddish in color. Instead of that, he uses the word shonitam. Shonitam actually means rudhiram or blood. Next one is anuchitartha. Anuchitartha, pashutam upagataha. Correct? That's what you saw, right? Pashutam upagataha. Rane pashutam upagataha, where a kavi is trying to describe a king who has who attained Viraswarga in the battlefield. And just like how a cow which is being sacrificed in a yaga attains a very great position, it attains a swarga, in the same way, a person who dies in the battlefield also attains Viraswarga. There he compares that king with a pashu and says, pashutam upagataha. And pashu indicates a cowardice, which is not what the poet wants to say, which is anuchitam as far as the king is concerned. Right? So, in the same manner, here the shloka he uses is kuvindastvam tavat patayasi gunagramam abhitaha yasho gayantyete dishi dishi cha nagnas tava vibho sharajyotsna gauras phutan vikata sarvanga subhagaha tathapi tvatkirtihi bhramati vigatachhadanam iha. Let us first look at how this shloka applies to the king. A kavi is praising the king and saying that you are protecting this earth by spreading your the qualities that you have. Guna gramam. Gramam means guna samuham. You are spreading this sadgunaha that you have in the entire world. Kuvindaha tvam. Kuvindaha. Ku is earth. And vindati means you are protecting this earth. Kuvindaha tvam. You are the lord of this earth. You are protecting this earth. Tvam tavat gunagramam abhitaha patayasi. Patayasi prasarayasi. Tvam gunagramam gunasamuham. Sva gunasamuham sarvatra abhitaha. Abhitaha means on both sides. You are spreading it. Both north and south or whatever, whichever, on all sides, abhitaha means. On all sides, you are spreading your good qualities. Kuvindastvam tavat gunagramam abhitaha patayasi prasarayasi. यशो गायन्ति एते दिशि दिशि नग्नाः, नग्नाः आर् स्तुतिपाठकाः, दोस् हू आर् बार्ड्स् हू प्रेज़् द किङ्ग्. सो जनरली द किङ्ग् हेज़् अ सेट् आफ् बार्ड्स् आर् सिङ्गर्स् हू कीप् मङ्गल पाठकाः आर् स्तुतिपाठकाः हू आर् कान्स्टेण्ट्लि प्रेज़िङ्ग् द किङ्ग् बिकास् द किङ्ग् नीड्स् नो कान्फिडेन्स् बूस्टिङ्ग् कान्स्टेण्ट्लि. Otherwise, he will be riddled with self-doubt and he won't be able to perform well. So he needs a confidence booster once in a while. So as there are, you know, in those days, there was no clock to show them time and all. These Tutipataka are people who have been trained to sing in their entire ancestors also used to sing. And they are also, they are employed by the king to sing about the time and everything. So they will sing about the Ritu, they will sing about the time, and along with that, they will also keep praising the king. That is their duty. So their duty is to sing the praise of the king. Hey Vibho, O king, tava yashaha ete nagnaha dishi dishi gayanti ete nagnaha. These stutipataka, these singers, sing your praise. Tava ete yashaha. Tava yashaha gayanti, they are singing your praise dishi dishi in all directions. Next, kintu tvat kirtihi, and not kintu or tathapi, and yet, even though they are singing, you can't say even though they are singing, you should say tathapi means as apicha, and further, tvat kirtihi, your fame, is roaming around everywhere without any cover. Vigata achadanam iha asmin bhumau, asyam bhumau, in this earth iha, tvat kirtihi, your fame is bhramati, roaming around, vigata achadanam, without any cover. And your kirti is white, like sharad jyotsna gauras puta vikata sarvanga subhaga. Your kirti, he is imagining the kirti as a lady, and the lady is roaming around with a lot of confidence without any diffidence, which means there is nothing to stop your fame from moving around the entire world, from wandering the world. So your fame just wanders into the world without any fetters, without any cover, means without any vignam. Vigata achadanam, achadanam vina, vastram vina is one meaning. Here you can say without any obstacle. Pratibandakam vina tava kirtihi iha bhumau sarvatra bhramati. How is that kirti? He is saying sarvanga subhaga. It is beautiful in all aspects. That is, you have so much of good qualities. So your fame is beautiful in every aspect. Sarvanga subhaga. And it is vikata, vipulam, vishala kirtihi. You have an extensive fame, which is puta, which is very clear, without any blemish. There is no apakirti for you. And it is gaura, hence it is white, like the sharad jyotsna, like the autumnal moon. So I've said in many places where the autumn season doesn't have any clouds, hence the moonlight is so beautiful, and the moon is also closer to the earth. And so you can see it more clearly. Hence the Sharad Jyotsna is very pure and white. So your kirti is also free of any blemish. There are no doshas in your kirti. And hence it is roaming around without any obstacle. Vigata Achadanam. Nice shloka? Huh. Now, the dosha here is, he is the poet, by using these words, he is actually conveying an anuchitartha, in the sense, not just, if you looked at that padagatam anuchitartham, it was only one word, whereas the rest of the entire shloka was beautiful. Only that pashutam gata indicated a cowardice for the king, whereas here, the entire imagery that comes to our mind, you can even say it is a Shabdashakti Mola Dvani, but the Dvani that comes out is so anuchitam or inappropriate that it is full of dosha. Why? He is comparing a king to a weaver. Kuvindaha is Rudhyartha, is a weaver. Tantuvayaha. Sir, one who makes clothes. So kuvindaha tvam patayasi patam karoshi. Whereas for the king, if you look at it, it is patayasi means prasarayasi, or patutarena patutaya patum karoshi, you can say. So patayasi, instead of that you can say nirmalena prasarayasi is better. Okay, gunagramam abhitaha prasarayasi. You are spreading your fame everywhere, your good qualities everywhere. Whereas for the weaver, tantuvayaha guna gramam, guna here means tantu, thread. Guna also means, in different shastra, it has different meanings. So even in kavyam, there are two meanings for this. One is guna, shaurya, virya, dana, ityadi gunaha, rajapakshe. Tantuvaya pakshe tu, gunaha iti tantavaha, which is threads. Red, white threads and all that. Now he uses those abhitaha, not in all directions, here in two directions. In Tamil we call it oodu paavu. Oodu is the horizontal thread, and paavu is the vertical thread, or one of those two. We use those two types of, so when you weave a cloth, you don't just use cloth horizontally, correct? You have to use the threads in a crisscross manner to weave a cloth. So that is abhitaha in both ways. So he uses gunagramam abhitaha upayujya. He uses the threads in both ways, horizontally and vertically. Patayasi, and you make a cloth. Patayasi patam karoshi. Vastram karoshi tvam. So kuvindaha, rudhya means by popular convention, a weaver is called kuvindaha. The first sentence is over. There itself we saw three words which give us a completely anuchitartha. You can't call a king who is a kshatriya, who protects the entire earth, as a weaver here. Now next is even worse. Nagnaha. Nagnaha means yesham vastram nasti. Vastrahinaha, those who are naked. So nagnaha tava yashaha gayanti. So those people who don't have any cloth are singing your praise because you give them cloth. The weaver is the person who makes the cloth and gives the cloth to the naked people. So the people who are naked, nagnaha tava yashaha gayanti, they are singing your praises in every direction. Vastra samriddhau api. No, even though you are making so much of cloth, so many different types of cloth for people, and people are praising you, even then, tava kirtihi vigata achchadanam bhramati. If the context was a weaver, the weaver would be very happy. I'm telling you, it's a gunam for the gunapuritam shlokam. So, you know, he's actually trying to praise a weaver that you're like a king. So then it would have been an ideal, wonderful shloka, because the context is fixed as the king. That is why it is a dosha. Okay? Because the context is prakaranike rajarupe arthe. That is important here. Yes, it is a Shabda Shakti Muladhvani. That's what I said, right? So Shabda Shakti Moolam means each and every word, if the prakaranikartha is a tantuvayaha. Let's say there is a tantuvaya who has, you know, a weaver who has beautifully weaved a cloth for the king. Then the king is wearing that cloth and he is looking resplendent. Now the king says to the kavi, why don't you praise that tantuvaya? Then the kavi talks about the tantuvaya. He does not want to let go of the king also. He wants to praise the king also, and he is talking to the tantuvaya. Then the shloka attains a different beauty here, and it is a dvani shloka, right? But unfortunately, he has taken this as an example for dosham. So we fix the context as Raja, and the meaning that arises in our mind is that of a tantuvaya, and hence we have to look at the other meaning. Now for the second half of the whole shloka goes for both the king and the tantuvaya, the weaver, is the same. So Sharad Jyotsna Gaura Sputa Vikata Sarvanga Subhaga, only that tathapi means even though you have weaved so many clothes, your kirti, your fame is moving or roaming around without any cover. Just the word tathapi and vigata achadanam have two meanings, different meanings, when it is in the Rajapaksha and in the Tantuvaya Paksha, Kuvinda Paksha. So in the Rajapaksha, we saw tathapi means apicha. Further, your kirti, your fame, vigata achadanam, vignam vina, pratibandhakam vina, tava kirtihi sarvatra bhumau bhramati. Here we take it as tathapi, even though vastra samriddhi bhave sate satyapi, samriddhi satyapi, tava kirtihi vastra achadanam vina bhramati sarvatra. That is your meaning for the Tantuvaya. Now this becomes anuchitam in the context of the king. Okay, then shloka kovindastvam tavat patayasi gunagramam abhitaha yashogayantyete dishi dishi cha nagnaha tava vibho sharad jyotsna gauras phuta vikata sarvanga subhaga tathapi tvatkirtihi bhramati vigata achhadanamiha. Atra kuvindadi shabdaha arthantaram pratipadayan, it gives another meaning. Upashlokyamanasya, upashlokyamanasya varnyamanasya prakriti yaha varnitaha saha raja upashlokyamanasya rajnyaha tiraskaram vyanakti. It is as if we are putting down the king here, right? Tiraskaram means a sort of a disrespect to the prakriti king here. So tiraskaram vyanakti, a suggestion of disrespect to the king is being shown here. Vyanakti iti anuchitartha. Hence, the dosha that is being highlighted in the shloka is anuchitartha. Just like that pashutam we saw in the earlier next one is avachakam. This avachakam is, there were two, three examples that we saw. Najata hardena jantuna. Jantu is the word that we saw before, where jantu should not be used as adata, a person who does not give charity. That is the meaning in which we had used jantu before. That is only one pada again. Here, he is going to use several words for that. Prabhra bhrad Vishnu dhamapya Vishama. Excuse me, just 1 minute. Yeah. Prabhra bhrad Vishnu dhamapya Vishamashvak karoti ayam nidram sahasraparnanam palayana parayanam. Now this shloka describes the rise of the sun, which is I am Vishamashvaha sahasraparnanam nidram palayana parayanam karoti. So he removes the nidra or the sleep of lotuses, which is the lotuses close their petals and it is like as if the lotuses are sleeping, and he removes the sleep from the lotuses, which means he makes the lotuses blue. That is the idea that is there in this shloka. So the Surya, I am Vishamashvaha. Vishama means odd number of ashva horses he has. So Surya is called Saptashvaha. Saptashvaha is more a word that is being used for Surya, whereas Vishamashva is not generally used for, it does not mean, see, we can say Vishamakshaha for Shiva, but we don't, Virupakshaha we can use, but we don't use Vishamashva for Surya at all. It does not even mean that. That is why it is called Avachakatvam. Avachakatvam means Shaktireva Nasti Tasmin Pade. To say, just like how Jantu the meaning of jantu could never have been adata, one who does not give. Or the word dinam can never mean prakashaha. It could only mean day. It could not mean light. So the same way, here also each and every word cannot mean what the poet intends to convey. Let us first look at what the poet intends to convey in these words. So, Prabhra Bhrat Vishnu Dhamma Aapya, I am Vishamashwaha. I am Vishamashwaha, this Surya who has an odd number of horses. So, Vishamashwaha, Surya. Prabhra Bhrat, Abhra Akashaha. Akashe Bhrat, Bhrajate. प्रकाशते आकाशे यहाँ प्रकाशते इति जलधः जलधरः मेघः सो दिस मेघ प्रकर्षेण यहाँ अभ्रे आकाशे प्रकाशते सो द क्लाउड विच और लेट्स से वेयर दिस क्लाउड इज प्रेजेंट तादृशं विष्णु धाम विष्णोः पदं स्थानम् Which is Akasha. So he is again coming back to Akasha here. Prabhrabrat is Megha. Megha yatra vartate saha Vishnoho dhama. Vishnoho sthanam, which is Akasham. So Akasham apya prapya, after coming to Akasha, this Surya Sahasraparnanam, the lotus which has 1,000 petals. So the 1,000-petaled lotus, Sahasradalanam or Kamalanam, Nidram, the sleep, Parayanam Karoti. Palayanaparayanam means it makes the sleep run away. He puts the sleep to flight or makes it run away. Palayanam means running away. Palayanaparayanam, the sleep completely flies away. Now here, such a bad shlokam that way. Okay. Prabhrabrat, the Upasarga pra cannot even come with this. Prakarshena Bhrajate, so that pra should actually be connected with the Bhrat. It cannot be combined with Abhra or Prakrishtaha. Abhrabrat cannot even connect to Megha. Next is Vishnudhama. Vishnudhama is generally used for Ganga. Vishnupadam is the sthanam for Ganga, and it is not used for Surya at all. Surya does not come to Vishnu's place there. So that is never. Tatra Shakti Nasti. We cannot get the meaning of it like that at all. But the poet wishes to convey that meaning. So Vishnudhama. Next is Vishamashwaha. Again, I told you Saptashwaha is used, but Vishamashwaha cannot be used. Vishamashwaha cannot mean Surya. Next is what is the next one? Nidra is okay. Nidra you can say Mukulitam, but Sahasraparnam means 1,000-leaf, whereas lotus is 1,000-petaled. So you have to use Sahasradala. The even in I think Sahasradala Padmakshi is used for Devi. Whereas Sahasraparna is never used for lotus. It does not, it cannot, it does not have the Shakti to convey the meaning of lotus. So Kamalam. Next is Nidra is not Sankocham. Again, he mentions that also. These are the words, the Prabhra Bhrat. Sahasradala Padmastha Sarvavarnopashobhita. Correct, in Lalitas' noun. Prabhrabhrat Vishnu Dhamma Vishamashva Nidra and then Parna Shabdaha Prakrishta Jalada Prakarshena Yaha Jaladaha Asti Tadrishaha Jaladaha So Prabhrabhrat तस्य विष्णुधाम इत्युक्ते मेघस्य धाम स्थानम यत् आकाशम दैट वर्ड इज ऑल्सो गॉन नेक्स्ट इज विषमाश्व इज सप्ताश्व इंस्टेड ऑफ सप्ताश्व ही इज यूजिंग विषमाश्व टू मीन सूर्य नेक्स्ट इज संकोच विच इज निद्रा एंड देन सप्तपर्ण इंस्टेड ऑफ सप्तदल ही इज यूजिंग सप्तपर्ण दैट इज ऑल्सो नॉट यूज्ड दीज आर ऑल इति शब्दानां अवाचकत्वम् एते शब्दाः प्राब्रब्राड विष्णुधाम विषमाश्व निद्रा पर्ण इति शब्दाः प्रकृष्ट जलद गगन पुट अ कॉमा आफ्टर एवरी वर्ड सो दैट इट्स इजियर फॉर यू टू अंडरस्टैंड गगन सप्ताश्व संकोच दलानां अवाचकाः दैट इज शक्ति न विद्यते तेषां तत्र तेषां तेषु अर्थेषु. ओके, दिस् इस् अवाचकत्वं. सो वि सा फैव् दोषस्. द नेक्स्ट् इस् अश्लीलम्. ऐ थिङ्क् वि विल् स्टाप् वित् दिस् बिकास् अश्लीलं हेस् त्री एक्साम्पल्स् देर्. So we will deal with that next class. Okay. Any doubts with this?